हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ किंजल बावसार, लेक्चरर इन एसी डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम वीपीएमपी पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज. सब्जेक्ट नेम माइक्रो प्रोसेसर इन असेंबली लैंग्वेज प्रोग्रामिंग. देन यूनिट नेम इंट्रोडक्शन टू माइक्रो प्रोसेसर. देन टॉपिक इज 8085 बस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. देन दीज आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माइक्रो प्रोसेसर बेस सिस्टम. Then 8085 bus organization, then 8085 base microcomputer system. So in first of all microprocessor base system, in this complete system microprocessor is interface with memory and input output device. And this system consists microprocessor, memory and input device. This whole system is known as a microprocessor based system, otherwise microcomputer based system. In this, input and output device are called peripheral devices. Then in this system, main function, otherwise main heart of the system is microprocessor. Then microprocessor is used to perform all arithmetic and logical operation. And all the activities in the system are performed under the control of microprocessor. Then it also synchronizes the operation using timing and control signal. Then in this system, this all parts, that means ki all peripheral devices connected with system bus. So what is system bus? System bus is a, normally bus is a group of wires. Then it provides the communication path between microprocessor and peripheral device. Then system bus of this microprocessor based system consists of address bus, data bus and control bus. Okay, that's why. Next, 8085 bus organization. So in 8085 bus organization, 8085 microprocessor connected with memory, input device and output device. Then in this, all the communication, otherwise data transfer bits from the microprocessor to peripheral device using this system bus. That means system bus, that means ki address bus, data bus and control bus. Then starting from data bus, this data bus is a bidirectional bus. Then it is used to, otherwise it allows the transfer of data between microprocessor and memory or peripheral device. This is the use of this data bus. Then specifically in 8085 microprocessor, data bus is 8-bit or bidirectional. Then which can carry 8-bit data, otherwise 8 bits of information at a time. Then next is address bus. So normally address bus is unidirectional bus. Then function of your address bus is carries address of memory location or port number of peripheral device. Then in specifically 8085 16-bit address bus A0 to A15. That's why number of lines in address bus, this number of lines A0 to A15 also determine the total amount of memory access by microprocessor. For example, in 8085 16-bit address bus, that's why 2 raised to 16, that means 64 kilobyte of memory. Memory means the total amount of 64 kilobyte of memory accessed by microprocessor 8085. Then last is a control bus. So a control bus, that means ki various control signals, that means ki single lines, and that carries the synchronization signal which use as a microprocessor and peripheral device communication. Then this for example microprocessor send appropriate signal to activate the memory device like read or write process. Okay, then These are the functions of each type of bus. First of all, data bus. Data bus is bidirectional bus, which allows the transfer of data between microprocessor or memory or peripheral device. Then, specifically in 8085, 8-bit bidirectional data bus, which can carry the 8-bit of information at time. जो आगे discuss किया वो. Then address bus. So address bus, unidirectional bus, which carries address of memory location or port number of peripheral device. Okay. In 8085 microprocessor, 16-bit address bus. Then number of lines in address bus also determines the total amount of memory accessed by microprocessor. Here example. In 8085 can access total 64 kilobyte of memory because it has a 16-bit address bus. Then control bus. Control bus consists of various signal lines that carries the synchronization signal, which act as a handshake signal between microprocessor and peripheral device. As an example, microprocessor send appropriate signal to activate the memory device for read or write data. Then this is the microcomputer based system using 8085 microprocessor. So in this four peripheral device means two memory, EEPROM, erasable programmable read only memory, then read write memory, that means key RAM, then input device and output device. So first of all, this data bus D0 to D7 connected with bidirectional, connected with this four device, memory, EEPROM, RAM and input device and output device. Then next, address bus in 8085 microprocessor, address bus divided into two part. A0 to A7 is called lower order address bus, and A8 to E15 is called higher order address bus. Then for memory purpose, this A0 to A15, that means ki total 16-bit address bus is used for memory purpose, and lower order address bus A0 to A7 is used for input and output purpose. That means ki to give the port address. That means memory contain address from 4x00 to 4xFF. And input and output device contain address 00 to FF. That means ki 8-bit lower order address bus. That means ki 2 raised to 8 to 256. That means ki you connect 256 input output device with 8085 microprocessor. This is the main fundamental of address bus. Then it also contain control bus. It generates control signals, four control signals, memory read, memory write, input output read, input output write. Then this control signals is connected with this four device. First, EEPROM. EEPROM, that means ki it only used for read purpose. That's why it contains only memory read signal. Then second is read write memory, that means ki RAM memory. So RAM contain read and write both signal. That's why two control signal, memory read and memory write, both are connected with this device. Then next is input device. So to enabling the input device from control signal IO read signal is enable the input device. Then at last, output signal is enabled by input output write signal. This is the total microcomputer based system. Thank you.